Dog training is recommended regardless of your lifestyle or the breed of your dog. In order to train your dog properly, you must take step-by-step actions. Go for a professional dog trainer that actually knows how to handle a dog. During previous training, the dog was taught to use his feet, teeth and strength to overcome various restraining devices. As we enter the building interior phase of training, those responses will begin to emerge as the positive alert we are attempting to develop. It will also become apparent that the searching of both occupied and unoccupied buildings presents the dog with numerous challenges. There will be, for example, many different and interesting odors present which may attract the dog's attention. In most cases, this serves as an asset, since the dog will be more inquisitive and examine objects much closer. The inside of a building contains numerous unpredictable air currents, even between walls, which will to some degree affect the dog's ability to detect. Therefore, you must always attempt to ascertain the direction of air currents and conceal the smell in a location where the odor will be available for detection. Initial training exercises should be conducted in an unoccupied building. Although you have conducted several building exterior detection exercises and the dog learned to stay close to the building as he examined, you should reinforce this by requiring him to closely examine the walls of the building interior before he is exposed to rooms with furniture and other objects. This phase of training provides an opportunity to teach the dog to work in a specific sequence as he hunts for smell odors. The air currents existing in the building or room you have selected for training will play a major role in accomplishing the objective. Therefore, this factor is of a primary concern. The amounts of smells used in each training exercise must be varied. This will accustom the dog to detecting various levels of the odor and prevent him from responding only to a specific scent level. Experience has clearly indicated that if we allow a specific level of a particular odor to represent reward achievement, the dog may not respond to greater amounts. At this point, the training is gradually becoming more difficult for the dog. Locations where the smell is being concealed is causing him to examine much closer in order to detect the odor, and he is having to exert more aggression to dislodge the odor and dummy. As you select an unoccupied building to conduct these exercises, it should be one that you can make several holes in the walls at various locations to conceal the smell and dummy. The walls should be of a soft type material such as fiberboard or plasterboard. The holes in the wall will allow the smell odor to be detected and provide a starting point for the dog to tear pieces of the wall away to retrieve the dummy and smell. This is an excellent enjoyable method to stimulate the dog's aggression toward the smell odor.